My name is Sergio Rua. I'm Principal DevOps at Digitalis. I'm going to show you today how we use Vault's operator to manage secrets in Kubernetes. At Digitalis, we manage multiple Kubernetes clusters for our customers. When you have many clusters to manage, it is a good idea to centralize your password management into a single solution or source of truth. This avoids secrets being updated in one place but not in another. For example, rotating a password but then not updating the client's configuration to use the new credentials. The problem we encountered is that each of our customers have a preferred secrets backend. Some are using cloud providers such as AWS, Google Cloud, or Azure, whilst others have on-premises HashiCorp Vault or even SOPs. Our solution to this problem is our Vault's operator. Vault's operator uses Vault's library, which supports multiple secrets engines. Vault's operator will keep any secrets in the backend secrets store in sync with the Kubernetes secrets. If you look into this Vault's secret definition, what I'm telling you here to do is to create a secret called MySecret and pull the data from, in this case, Vault, HashiCorp Vault. So it's going to take the data from this path, and it's going to create a secret based on the contents of the data in Vault. If we look at the data in Vault, you can see that I've got a secret prepared. It's called the username Sergio, and the password is this password is in Vault. If I now apply the secret, you see that straight away secret has been created. If we check now, just can confirm that the secret contains the same password by looking into the contents of the secret. And you can see the secret matches. Now, what I can do now is actually I can update the password anytime with a new secret. And that will update the Kubernetes secret automatically within 10 seconds, which is my TTL. So if I just put a new secret, it already called straight away a secret has been updated, and we can confirm that the new password has been created. Important thing to mention is that I have configured a TTL of 10 seconds. It means that the secret is not going to be updated unless the TTL has been reached. It's important to do this because some providers such as AWS or Google will charge you for using their secrets store. So the fewer connections you make to them, the better. If you use on-premises like HashiCorp Vault, like I'm using right now, it doesn't really matter. So this is one of the features we can do with Vault's operator. But the new one we just introduced is to be able to rotate passwords and sync them into a database as well. So let's look into the second example I've got prepared for you. This is quite similar to before. The contents initially are the same, but I have changed the backend just for demonstration purposes. And now my username data is coming from an S3 bucket, which contains a db.yaml config file. Same for the password, it comes from a bucket and a YAML file. Now, the additional to it is now we've got databases section. So what I'm telling the Vault operator to do, it's once the password's been updated in my backend, S3 in this case, I wanted to sync the same password to the Postgres databases and the MySQL database. So I'm gonna clean up the secrets from before first. So the secret's been now deleted. I'm gonna create a new one using the data from the second one. We look into the logs, you can see the secret's been once more created or updated. And there are two additional steps in here, which is the password has also been synced successfully to Postgres and to MySQL. Postgres in here, MySQL in here. if we look into the contents of the secret, like we were doing before, we have as password AWS password. And as you now be able to connect to the database using that password, let's connect to Postgres. So I'm using AWS password as password and connect successfully. Okay, let's now update the password. I've got my config file in here. It's gonna change the password to AWS password 111. And I'm gonna copy the new password to the stored. Okay, that's being done, and you can see straight away how the Vault operator picked up the new changes, and both my MySQL and Postgres database being updated. So we'll connect before to Postgres. Let's connect now to MySQL to confirm. So my new password is AWS password 111. Yeah, so success. So we can also confirm that the other one, sorry. Also confirm that the secret has been updated with the new password. So now that keeps my secrets in sync between database, my secrets store. In this case, I've been using S3 bucket and HashiCorp Vault and Kubernetes. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.